Hola amigos, welcome back to Learn Spanish World. This is Mr. Briggs, bringing you a new video entitled How to Say Drive Carefully in Spanish. Hola, hola, ¿qué tal amigos? It's been a few days. Actually, I hadn't uploaded a video like this since last year, but I'm back here once again, and I've got you a very important phrase that we can learn together. Yes, how to say drive carefully in Spanish. Are you ready to continue expanding your vocabulary with me? Fantastic. But before we commence, don't forget, click that button and subscribe. Hopefully this year we'll be able to reach 100,000 subscribers. I can't wait. Comencemos. Let's commence. Por favor, make sure that you listen carefully and repeat after me, copying my pronunciation. Escucha y repite. Listen and repeat. Drive carefully. Maneja con cuidado. Maneja con cuidado. Maneja con cuidado. Maneja con cuidado. Drive carefully. If you want to say drive carefully, it's raining, you'd say maneja con cuidado. Está lloviendo. Maneja con cuidado. Está lloviendo. Drive carefully. It's raining. Maneja con cuidado. Está lloviendo. Sleep well and drive carefully, or sleep well and drive safe, please. You would say, duerme bien y maneja con cuidado, por favor. Duerme bien y maneja con cuidado, por favor. This conveys the same idea as driving safe or carefully. Maneja con cuidado. Now, if you want to say, drive carefully, your family is waiting for you, you'd say, maneja con cuidado, tu familia te espera. Maneja con cuidado, tu familia te espera. Maneja con cuidado, tu familia te espera. Next one, siguiente. Drive carefully. I need you here with me. Maneja con cuidado. Te necesito aquí conmigo. Maneja con cuidado. Te necesito aquí conmigo. Maneja con cuidado. Te necesito aquí conmigo. Drive carefully. Maneja con cuidado. Maneja con cuidado. Maneja con cuidado. Drive carefully. Maneja con cuidado. Repeat after me. Maneja con cuidado. You can also say, drive carefully by saying, conduce con cuidado. Conduce and maneja are synonyms. They both mean drive. Conduce con cuidado. O maneja con cuidado. They mean exactly the same thing. And both expressions are fully understood across the Spanish-speaking world. Muy bien. Spanish listening exercises with Mr. Briggs. Aquí vamos. Here we go. ¿Cómo te fue? ¿Cómo te fue means how did you go? ¿Cómo te fue? As I said to you many times last year, it's very important for you to listen carefully and to repeat. So if you haven't done so, make sure you rewind the video and watch it again and practice aloud. That way, you will be able to get the correct pronunciation and you will also memorize it for good. Okay, so now we're going to talk in Spanish to practice our listening skills. Are you ready? ¿Estás listo? Muy bien, comencemos. Han pasado muchos días y no había podido subir videos porque pasaron muchas cosas en mi vida personal. Pero ahora, nuevamente, estoy de regreso y con más energía para continuar adelante. Tengo sorpresas muy interesantes que subiré en forma de videos en los próximos días. Fui a explorar una misteriosa laguna en medio de la nada. Te invito a que te prepares a acompañarme en una aventura donde verás lo hermoso de ese lugar y también aprenderás español. En unos días más, subiré el video. Durante diciembre, tuve que manejar con cuidado, porque algunas personas beben mucho cuando están manejando sus automóviles. Así es que yo manejé con cuidado. Yo manejo con cuidado todos los días. Yo manejaré con cuidado cuando vuelva a trabajar en la escuela. Ahí te di 3 ejemplos de cómo utilizar la frase que aprendiste hoy en el pasado. Yo manejé con cuidado, which means I drove carefully. Yo manejé con cuidado. Y cuando hablo del presente, yo digo, yo manejo con cuidado, which means I drive carefully. Y el futuro también, yo manejaré con cuidado. I will drive carefully. Recuerda, practica y repasa. De esa forma, aprenderás esta importante frase. Fantástico. ¿Cómo te fue? How did you go? ¿Cómo te fue? ¿Lograste escuchar y comprender lo que dije? Were you able to listen and comprehend what I said? Fantástico if you did so. But if you didn't, it's not the end of the world. Make sure you follow the subtitles and you also memorize the phrase. Repetition is so important. The other day I was reading an article in the internet about the importance of languages and the use of repetition. I'll see if I can link that interesting article. Muy bien, amigos. As I said to you, I got a lot of surprises for 2023. I'm currently working in a new format of videos. I already uploaded a blog a couple of months ago, and I will upload another blog in order to help you improve your Spanish. So stay tuned. That's coming in the next few days. Muy bien, amigos. Thank you so much once again. Don't forget to subscribe. Click that red button. It's not red anymore, but where it reads subscribe. And I hope to see you sometime this week once again. Take care. Cuídate. Chao, chao.